In this lecture, I am going to continue the properties of autocorrelation function. So, the next property is if the random process x of t has a periodic component then the autocorrelation function r sub x of tau will also have a periodic component. With the same frequency or frequencies, so the interesting part is that the frequency do not change or frequencies do not change depending on what you test, frequency or frequencies. So one of the trivial cases is if capital X of t, that is your random process, is let's say A times cosine of omega naught t plus some phase capital theta. This is a capital theta. Okay. So by looking at this, this is a periodic function. X of t is a periodic. By different phase, you will get a different waveforms. Now you understand why you introduced the deterministic random process. By the way, this is an example of deterministic random process. I am using the short notation RP for random process, where capital theta is a random variable and you assume that theta is uniformly distributed. So when I say uniformly distributed, then what is the range of theta here in this one? Theta, what is the range of theta? It is going to be 0 to 2 pi. Therefore, we assume that the density function f theta of theta is uniformly distributed over the range 0 to 2 pi. This is 2 pi, 0, and this is your density function. So, what will be this value? And that is going to be 1 over 2 pi. Therefore, this f theta of theta is naturally will be 1 over 2 pi. Okay. Now, as I said, your x of t, capital X of t, is A times cos of omega naught t plus theta. And this is periodic because your cos function is periodic. Now, if I calculate the autocorrelation function of this random process, let's say rxx of tau, which is x of t1 times x of t2. What we mean by this? Let's say this theta can take any value between 0 to 2 pi. It can take 0 degree or 0.1 degree or 0.001 degree or 2 pi degree, anything you can take. So when I say 0, then your waveform like this. When you say some other phase angle, then it slightly shifted version of that. So like this, how many waveforms can I have it? Like this, I can have infinite number of waveforms because there are infinite number of values in between 0 to 2 pi because it is a continuous values. So it takes continuous value from 0 to 2 pi. So I have infinite number of waveforms. So what do? I sample the process at t equal to t1 and again sample the process at t equal to t2, and the time difference is tau. Your t2 equal to t1 plus tau. So the moment you do the sampling, you'll get a random variable x of t1 at the time instant t1, and here you get x of t2. So there are two random variables by sampling the random process x of t, right? So for these random variables, I am finding the autocorrelation function. Now for simplification, let us assume that t equal to t1 and t2 equal to t1 plus tau. Already we assumed t equal to t1, therefore this is t plus tau. So t2 equal to t plus tau and t equal to t1 plus tau. We substitute in this equation. So this is going to be x of t times x of t plus tau. Now we know what is x of t. You can substitute here. It is a times cos of omega naught t plus theta big theta. Big theta multiplied by a times cos of omega naught t plus omega naught tau plus theta. And a times a, it is a constant a square. You can pull out from this expectation a square times expected value of cos of omega naught t plus theta times cos of omega naught t plus omega naught tau plus theta. Now why theta again? Here also theta and here also theta. Why theta again? Why not some other value? Because theta is a random variable, and because it is an autocorrelation, we are taking x of t1 and x of t2 from the same process. Say this is my random process. Same process, from the same process I am taking two values. Suppose if I consider another function, let's say b times cos of omega naught t plus theta 1, then I can have denote different functions like this. There are many I can have another process like this. So here if you sample, then you can write as b times cos of omega naught t plus theta 1 times b times cos of omega naught t plus omega naught tau plus theta 1. Okay, so because this is a separate process, and here you can do the sampling at t equal to t1 and here t equal to t2, then you write the expression like this. Therefore, the theta 1 comes from the same random process. Therefore, for another member of the family, if it is capital theta 1, then for both x of t1 and x of t2, you have theta 1 and theta 1. So in this case, the autocorrelation function is like this. Now it is a matter of trigonometry. Now to expand this into a sum of two cosines. So take this one and expand it to sum of two cosines. So it is equal to a square times expected value of cos of omega naught tau plus cos of 2 omega naught t plus 2 omega naught tau plus 2 theta. And expectation is a linear operation. You can take it inside. By the way, here the factor 2 will come. So a square by 2 expected value of cos of omega naught tau plus a square by 2 expected value of cos of 2 omega naught t plus 2 omega naught tau plus 2 theta. Now by definition, you know how to expand this. We know the formula. Suppose if you have e of x equal to integral of x times fx of x into dx. By the similar manner, you can write as a square by 2 integral of cos omega naught tau and f theta of theta times d theta. And for the second one, a square over 2 integral of cos of 2 omega naught t. Omega naught t plus 2 omega naught tau plus 2 theta. Note down, I am using small theta here. Theta times f theta of theta times d theta. Because the random variable is theta, so that's why we are doing the integration with respect to theta. Okay, and the limit is from 0 to 2 pi. Your theta ranges from 0 to 2 pi. Now, you substitute this f theta of theta, that is 1 over 2 pi, and the cos of omega naught tau is a constant. You can pull out of the integration. So, it is a square by 2. A square by 2 cos omega naught tau integral of 0 to 2 pi, and this is going to be 1 over 2 pi, the density function, times d theta. And anyway, the area under the density function, it is equal to 1 plus a square by 2 integral of 0 to 2 pi. You cannot take this outside because it is a function of theta. So cos of 2 omega naught t plus 2 omega naught tau plus 2 theta times 1 by 2 pi times d theta. Now if you carry out this integration, then this will lead to 0. That you can check it out. It's a simple trigonometric value. And finally, you will end up with a square by 2 cos of omega naught tau. So this is the autocorrelation function of a periodic random process. Okay. So that means what? Wait a minute. If x of t, capital X of t, is a periodic component, or x of t has a periodic component, then look at this rx of tau. Rx of tau will also have periodic component, okay, with the same period. Therefore, same period and same frequency. Frequency also same. See, x of t is a times cos of omega naught t plus big theta. So here also the frequency is omega naught, and in the autocorrelation frequency, in the autocorrelation also, the frequency is omega naught. The frequency does not change. So both the random process and the autocorrelation function has the same frequency, omega naught. And you can also show, now it is a matter of no algebra, if x of t was like a times cos of omega naught t plus theta plus some other component which is non-periodic, let's say n of t, some noise component. So this is not periodic, and this one is the periodic part. So it has a periodic component. Then you can show that, simply you can show that rxx of tau is equal to a square by 2 cos of omega naught tau plus the autocorrelation function of the noise component, and this is non-periodic and this part is periodic with the same frequency what you have for the random process. Here also you have omega naught, and here also you have omega naught. So what we learned today is that the autocorrelation function is a faithful reflection of the nature of the random process. This is a very important point to remember, reflection of the nature of the random process. If the random process has a DC component, then autocorrelation function will also have a DC component, or vice versa. If the autocorrelation function has a DC component, then the random process must have a DC component. Similarly, if the autocorrelation function has a periodic component, then the random process must also have a periodic component. So it's kind of no reflection. So it exactly reflects the nature of the random process. Okay, if you take a random process x of t and it has a periodic component, then your Rxx of tau also have, tau also has a periodic component with the same frequency. So it is no kind of reflection of your random process. Similarly, when I say x of t has a DC component, then Rxx of tau also has it, the vice versa also. That means this implies this and this implies that. Rxx of tau implies x of t and x of t implies Rxx of tau. So if the autocorrelation function has a DC component, then x of t also will also have a DC component. If x of t has a DC component, then Rxx of tau will also have a DC component. When I say DC component, what do we mean by that? That means the mean is not equal to 0. That is what DC component. If somebody says the random process has a DC component, that means what? The mean value is not equal to 0. If mean equal to 0, what we mean by mean? Mean is average. Average. That average is not equal to 0. So essentially DC means you are finding the average value, right? So if you have a sinusoidal frequency, you are finding the average value. How do you find the average? You first, you know, square this waveform. Let's say it is sine omega t. Then how do you find the DC component of this? First you square this, then find the area of this, and again take a square root of that and divide by the total period. So that is your DC component. So DC component is nothing but an average value. So whenever you say a random process has a DC component, that means the average value is non-zero. That is, the mean is non-zero. Okay, so that's all about this property. So this property says, so if x of t has a periodic component, then R of the autocorrelation function Rxx of tau will also have a periodic component with the same frequency or multiple frequencies. Let's say your random process contains two frequencies, then your autocorrelation function also will have two frequencies. That's it. So that's why I use the word frequency or frequencies. And the next property is, if x of t is ergodic, comma, zero mean. Just now I told you what we mean by zero mean, okay? Zero mean and has no periodic component. Then the following thing holds: limit mod of tau goes to infinity Rxx of tau. What do you think this is going to be? Zero. Now when I say zero mean, what we mean by that? It is DC component is non-zero. It means sorry, 0 mean means like mean equal to 0. Mean equal to 0 means average value equal to 0. Average value equal to 0 means what? DC value equal to 0. That means DC component is 0 in this case. And ergodic means what? Time average is equal to statistical average. Your time average x bar equal to E of x, and time autocorrelation function Rxx of tau is equal to statistical average Rxx of tau. This is the definition of ergodic process. Okay. Now, when tau goes to infinity, then Rxx of tau goes to 0. Why? Because when tau is very large, the similarity, if any, is lost. See, you have a waveform like this. Let's say this is my x of t. Now, x of t plus tau, it's a shifted version of the original function. Okay, time advanced version of the original function, x of t plus tau. X of t minus tau means delayed version, and x of t plus tau is the advanced version of the x of t. So the function starts little early, and when tau goes to infinity means you are shifting the function or advancing the function by infinite amount. So in that case, if you multiply this and that, this is x of t, the same function, maybe no, I cannot draw here since it is a random waveform. Now shift like this and multiply these two guys, x of t and x of t plus tau, where tau goes to infinity, that means you are shifting by infinite amount. So that means there is no similarity between this waveform and this form, this waveform. If there is no similarity, then naturally you can say that the autocorrelation function is zero. That means what? On an average, how one function is depending on the other, how you can predict the one with other. So that's what your autocorrelation function. So from common sense argument, it follows that it can also be proved, it follows that, okay, from common sense point of view, you can say that the Rxx of tau is equal to 0 if tau goes to infinity. It can also be proved rigorously, but we shall not do it here. Okay, so it is not necessary, it is out of scope of our course, so we will not be prove that. But anyway, for conceptually, the autocorrelation function is going to be 0 when tau is equal to 0. And this statement is valid only for ergodic process. Because when I say ergodic, then I can find out the statistical autocorrelation from the time autocorrelation function. And time autocorrelation function, we know how to calculate. Time autocorrelation function is you multiply x of t and the infinite shifted version of x of t plus tau times dt, and the limit is minus t to plus t, and take average, time average, and allow t goes to infinity. So this is the time average. Sorry, time autocorrelation function. From this, you can find out the statistical autocorrelation. When tau goes to infinity, there is no overlap between x of t and x of t plus tau. So in that case, naturally, you can expect the autocorrelation function is going to be 0. And one more property, let me see if time permits, I will complete that. The next property is the autocorrelation function Rxx of tau cannot have an arbitrary shape. You can take one function and you can claim that is an autocorrelation function. That is not possible. Okay, because this property simply says that any arbitrary function cannot be an autocorrelation function. Why? Because the autocorrelation function has many properties. It is an even function, first of all, is equal to Rxx of minus tau. Just now we have seen that if tau goes to 0, then Rxx of tau also should go to 0. If tau goes to infinity, right? And in the previous lectures also we have seen some properties. Therefore, simply you cannot take one function and say that this is an autocorrelation function of a random process. So that is not at all possible. And moreover, this fact will be more apparent when we talk about power density spectrum that I will introduce at later point in this course. So it will be shown there in a power density spectrum that autocorrelation function is related to the power density spectrum through the Fourier transform pair. So that we will see a little later. Your autocorrelation function forms the Fourier transform pair. If you take a Fourier transform, then you'll get a power spectral density SX of omega, or sometimes people write SXX of F. So these two forms a pair, Fourier transform pair. If you take any something or arbitrary function, then you cannot obtain this power density spectrum. So you cannot choose any arbitrary function as an as a autocorrelation function of the random process. So with this point, let me stop. So in the next lecture, let me continue from this point. Thank you.